Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we're going to change the type of ceremony just a little bit. And I would ask that you all stand for one moment of silent prayer in honor of the next awardee. Amen. You may be seated. Leslie T. Welsh, president of Leslie T. Welsh, Inc., the young man who lost his arm in a farming accident when he was 15 years of age, and he was told at that time that a one-armed man, he wasn't capable of handling the requirements of college. Well, Leslie not only graduated from the University of Illinois with a degree in accounting, but he was awarded football's All-State Honorable Mention as an offensive guard. His career ranged from being a partner at Arthur Anderson and Company, then a stint with Voigt Harness, and through a series of mergers, he was named president of Studebaker-Worthington, Inc. in 1971. His company, Leslie T. Welsh, Inc., is involved in several diverse businesses today, ranging from commercial real estate development to manufacturing, to advertising, to chartering aviation equipment, breeding of thoroughbred horses and cattle. Unfortunately, ladies and gentlemen, Leslie Welsh died of a heart attack on April 26, as we look forward to this evening. Charles Lewin, from the class of 1968, and a longtime friend of Mr. Welsh, will make the presentation to an extremely outstanding young man, Bob Welsh, who will accept the Horatio Alger Award on behalf of his father. Gentlemen.
Done it. convinced that he was fortunate. From the football coach that put this one-armed kid back into the game to the assistant football coach that taught him bookkeeping and sparked an interest in college and a professional career, to Leonard Spotchek of Arthur Anderson, who is here tonight, Daryl Ruttenberg of Studebaker-Worthington, and Charles Lubin, the founder of Sara Lee, and his host here tonight, Dad knew that he had had help along the way. He especially wanted to acknowledge the love and support of his family, my brother Tom, and my sisters Barbara and Cindy, and especially to his wife Mary Lee. He often said that without her help, he never could have done it. And while Dad met with difficult circumstances, he constantly discovered new resources in himself and in the people around him. Like Thomas Jefferson, Dad believed that America is a land where we dream of an aristocracy of achievement, arising out of a democracy of opportunity. He believed, and I believe, that it is the uses to which we put this adversity that creates the aristocracy. And while Dad would wish prosperity to each one of you tonight, he would wish you just enough adversity to get you there. Thank you very much.